memories on a beautiful, nice and cloudy day in Kigali, the land of a thousand hills, Rwanda. It's been raining throughout the night, which is really quite beautiful. Yesterday we went to Lake Kivu. Quite nice, and checked out the border town of Goma, that's in the DRC, that was great. And we were able to even get a better view of these thousand hills. There's probably more. They could come to a thousand and say that we're tired now, but it's far too many, which makes the country look beautiful. Our flight to here, of course, was courtesy of the great African airline Rwanda, and we appreciate them very much. We really thank you. Ruben Boni is the senior manager. Good morning, sir.
Hey, good morning.
Thank you for bringing us here. So you cover which part of the area of destinations?
Okay, basically I cover Rwanda, the entire Rwanda, and Eastern Congo. So the Eastern Congo is probably where you visited. That's Goma, mainly because of the region. So what I do is oversee the sales of these areas, ensure that our clients are getting the best rates, and to stay competitive.
I mean, Africa is growing in terms of air travel. We know the demand is going to grow even more. What are you seeing since you oversee that area? What are you seeing in the area that you cover?
Well, definitely we've seen a lot of growth over time. And if you look at where we started from, which was almost close to 15 years ago, if I may say, that was way back in 2002. So over time, what we've seen is an increase in demand. Definitely, we are yet to cover all areas that we want, but at least we've seen a significant growth over time, and the demand is still there, and it's growing every day. People improving purchasing power.
In terms of the area, I'm curious about the Eastern Congo as well and Rwanda. What kind of traveler is going up and down in those areas of yours, typically?
We have various kinds of travelers. We have what we call the corporate travel. We also have the traders who form the majority of our market segments. So most of them you'll find the biggest chance would be traveling the middle, Dubai, where we fly to, we operate a daily flight to Dubai. So yeah, most of those are the traders. Then we also have students. We also have what we can call the premium travelers. Once in a while, that's from again the biggest segment that we have.
Okay, as Air Rwanda, what is so unique about the airline that you say, look, fly with us, especially within the destinations that I've mentioned that I manage?
Well, what stands out about from there is one, we operate the latest fleet. Our fleet are very young compared to all other carriers, and most of them are modern, if I may say. We have Wi-Fi equipped planes. I don't know if you got a chance to experience that while you're flying.
I saw that and I thought, let me just sleep a bit. But I saw it written there, Wi-Fi enabled.
Yeah, it's Wi-Fi enabled. So you can surf on board at the same time. You can also still do calls while you're flying. So again, when it comes to the kind of leadership that we already have that has enabled the carrier to grow to this extent, means that we are able to offer the best service in terms of our fares. We have the most competitive rates in the market, and which is what people have really seen and enjoyed. Having a young fleet, having competitive fares, makes us top notch.
And in terms of the volume of flights, are you planning to add more? What are you seeing?
Yeah, definitely we are growing, like I said, and we can speak more destinations as we go on. In fact, a few days from now, which will be on the 27th, we'll be flying now to Abuja, which is in Nigeria. We're adding one of our destinations there, that's on the 27th. And then next month, on the 16th, we'll start Cape Town flights.
Oh, you go